Sacktown. What up, though, and welcome to another video, LLCTP, presented to you by Limitless Lifestyle Crew. Please follow us at limitlesslifestylecrew.com and also visit the Instagram page at Limitless Lifestyle Crew, all one word. This video is sponsored by nobody. I'm your host, JT, JTown32. If you want to follow me on any of the social sites, Instagram, Twitter, that's mainly where you'll see me rippling, rambling. Got a few things boiling up for everyone to kind of take a look. I don't have any shoes or any clothes or anything to review in that sort. But I'm coming today because NBA free agency, we are 1 week into NBA free agency. And if you see me looking, I'm looking at my computer because I have pretty much the free agency tracker that I'm looking at. And you don't necessarily need it, but when you look at the figures as far as the dollars that have been spent for free agency, it's crazy. Now, today is Sunday. Free agency started a week ago, last Sunday at 6 o'clock. And the biggest domino for free agency, everyone already knew, was Kawhi Leonard. Kawhi Leonard was the biggest domino. Everybody wanted to know if he would go to Toronto or if he would go to the Clippers. And then more recently, within like the last maybe month, I don't even know if it's been a month, but the Lakers have become a serious contender, especially with their acquisition of Anthony Davis from the Pelicans. So Friday, you see a whole bunch of deals being done. We got Kevin Durant and Kyrie teaming up to go to Brooklyn. They also brought DeAndre Jordan with them. That's crazy. Tobias Harris is going to stay in Philly, but Jimmy Butler is out of Philly. Jimmy Butler decided to go to the Heat, and it's kind of weird because he docks me as someone who's going to win. Now, I do think they'll be highly competitive just because the East, that bottom, you know, those bottom seeds in the East, I think the Pistons were the bottom seed last year. I could see Jimmy Butler in the Cavs kind of, you know, depending on who that Cavs is. Now, when we get to some of the things that have going on in free agency, that Cavs might change. I know he still has Dragic right now. I don't know if they're going to keep Dragic. He still has Justice Winslow. Hassan Whiteside is gone. He's in Portland. But he's more so just like a backup until Big Nurkic is healthy. Once Nurkic is healthy, then they'll not get rid of him, but he'll go to the bench, and then Nurk will be the starting center. Other big deals, Kemba Walker leaving Charlotte, and he had been with Charlotte his entire career. So I don't know how many years he's been in. He's been in the league a while now, so it's probably been about 8-9 years, something like that, something crazy, man. So he's going to Boston to replace Kyrie, essentially. Terry Rozier, who was talking all kind of crazy about what he had to sacrifice playing on that Boston team, he is going to Charlotte. So essentially just a three-team swap with all, you know, getting those point guards. Because Kyrie is going to Brooklyn, D'Angelo Russell is out. And D'Angelo Russell is with the Warriors, who don't have Klay for the first half of the season, but they have D'Angelo Russell now, so they have another person to score the basketball on his own who doesn't need much help to score the basketball. A lot of people are kind of saying he doesn't play the Golden State style of basketball, and that may be true, but he gets buckets. So Golden State, their style of basketball is get buckets. So threes, twos, whatever that is, D'Angelo Russell can definitely fill a void for the time being that Klay Thompson is out. Andre Iguodala is no longer with the Warriors. So they took a big hit losing Iguodala and Durant. And we don't know if Sean Livingston is going to retire. So for the Warriors, it's going to be interesting to see. I still have them at like a 5-6 seed. That may be a little too high, maybe more 6-7-ish, you know, for them. But until somebody shows me otherwise, I'm not counting them out. So another big move, and I think this happened, may have happened during the playoffs, was Mike Conley going to Utah. Now, Utah got a lot better, and that's a playoff team, so they got a lot better. Houston didn't make any moves, so and it's not like they really had to. They were, what, the number two seed? So it's not like two or three, something like that, but it's not like they had to make a whole bunch of moves. They were pretty good, but just seeing that everyone else made some moves, you expect Houston to, because you know Daryl Morey is kind of wild, so whatever with that. But the big domino, KD, but KD isn't playing all next year. So Kyrie will shoulder the load. Kyrie and DeAndre Jordan. Kyrie mainly will shoulder the load for the Brooklyn Nets. So that's going to be kind of crazy to see. But Friday night or Saturday morning when the news actually broke, we finally, after just about a week, we finally got news about Kawhi Leonard. So he had flew earlier in the week, he had flew to Toronto. And a lot of people were, it's crazy how many, you know, sports writers and, you know, all of these, you know, sports talents were saying, oh, he's 99% going to the Lakers. He's 99% going to the Raptors. He can't be 99% going to both. So he flew to Toronto, I guess, to have his last meeting. And they were saying, I remember them saying, we know Kawhi's quiet, so he doesn't like a lot of noise. But they were saying the team, that the Clippers were out. Everybody said the Clippers were out because they couldn't get another star, blah, blah, blah. You know, it's between the Lakers and the Raptors. And Friday night, Saturday morning, boom, you hear Kawhi's going to the Clippers. And as soon as you hear that Kawhi's going to the Clippers, while you're reading that tweet or whatever message you got, you get another message saying that Paul George has been traded to the Clippers for about 4 or 5 draft picks. I don't know, a whole bunch of draft picks. And now you have the Clippers as a contender. They're the favorite for a lot of people, and I don't see why they wouldn't be. They still have Patrick Beverley. So you're going to have a defensive line with Patrick Beverley, Kawhi Leonard, and Paul George, all top-tier defenders. All three of them top-tier defenders. So it's going to be tough. Paul George is hurt. He just had surgery on his shoulder, so he'll be out for like probably the first couple of weeks. But once he gets back, it won't even matter. Like, they'll have a team that can hold most teams in an era where scoring is key. Like, defense, they really, I don't think, they kind of shit on it, man. Like, the NBA doesn't want you to play strict defense, but they'll be able to, you know, they'll be able to strap up on some teams. So, I'm interested to see this Clippers team. I'm interested to see AD and LeBron and Kuzma and see his progression. Danny Green was waiting on Kawhi, so he's going to the Lakers. Now, I'm not understating the AD because that's the biggest thing, but I think the Lakers should have been more aggressive in getting a point guard. But, you know, they waited for Kawhi, and there's nothing wrong with that. Kawhi is the biggest domino, so you wait for him. But I'm interested to see the Lakers and the Clippers, and they're still in the same division as the Warriors and Sacramento. So that division is going to be crazy. Sacramento didn't get worse either. They added a couple more wing players. They lost Colley Stein, who actually went to the Warriors. So Colley Stein and D'Angelo Russell are the two big pickups for the Warriors. But every team got better. Every team got better, especially in that division. So Nets, much of a wash this year. Unfortunately for the Knicks, they kind of washed out. They didn't get anybody. But nobody likes the owner. And everybody keeps saying sell a team and they think it's a joke and all that, but it's really not a joke. Sell a team. If you can't get any talent in there, sell a team. But the NBA, this offseason, it's been crazy, man. I've seen some crazy stuff, but it's just amazing how the NBA is literally a 365-day sport. We talk about basketball every day, and part of it being because of free agency, summer league, and then the access. I'm excited. I'm excited to see how Kawhi fares going to the Clippers. I know he wanted to go back home to California, not necessarily L.A. He's not from L.A., but he's from California. So he's happy to go back home. I'm sure his family's happy to have him. But it does suck for Toronto because you have all of these. They got maybe 2 young people and a bunch of older players. So to see what they're going to do, you know, do they take another run at it without their star? Or do they, you know, trade their old pieces and gather assets? Because you can trade the old pieces for, you know, draft picks to contending teams who need pieces like maybe a Kyle Lowry or Marc Gasol or a Serge Ibaka, etc. So it's gonna be you know, fun to watch. It's a lot of things to watch. With me saying that OKC has traded Paul George, what we do know is Russell's out. Russell's gonna leave. He's gonna get traded simply because there's no point in him staying. They traded him for Shai Gilgeous-Alexander, and I can't even remember who else, but I know it was like a lot of picks that the Clippers got. So they, Gallinari, Gilgeous Alexander and Gallinari are going to OKC, but that's not a team that can make the West. Like, it's not a team that can make the West. So I think if I had to bet, they said the Pistons want Russ, Miami would take him, and the Timberwolves. If I'm a betting man, I'm going to say he ends up in Miami with Jimmy Butler, and they make the playoffs. So I'm excited to see it. Thank you for, you know, watching another episode of Limitless Lifestyle Crew, LLC TV. Subscribe, comment. Let me know what you think of all of these free agency moves. This is what I do. I talk basketball. I love basketball. I talk it all day. So let me know what you think of these free agency moves in the comments below. I'll talk with you. Make sure we respond. I have another video shortly. As you can see, the room's kind of coming together. Got futons and everything. It's coming together real nicely. But thank y'all for tuning in. I hope to hear from y'all soon. Subscribe, like, share. LimitlessLifestyleCrew.com. Limitless Lifestyle Crew on Instagram. If you're metro, don't trust you, I'm gonna shoot.